Yeah, I'm right there with you, especially since Biden took office. And at least before then, as shitty as Trump was, at least he was getting somewhat checked by the media. Granted, it was over mostly like this Russiagate shit that turned out to be a whole bunch of nothing. And but now that the golden boy, Sleepy Joe, has taken over, it's now gotten to the point where not only you got the mainstream media in their back pocket, you have the little toadies, the little fan club, the Jim Jones Kool-Aid drinkers, who will just defend them to the hilt. And you say, well, what have they done? You know, I'm like you. I don't think electoral politics is going to do jack squat at this point. We have to apply immense outside pressure on these people.
Before, and it could have been done, right? Before, maybe, but not at this point.
Right. Exactly. I mean, look at them now. They're just actors in a play.
They're actors. That's what I'm saying. Actors. It's like, I've been in that world. I know when people are faking it. Like, they're actors, essentially, right now. Like, this is like, it's just so crazy to me. Like, the whole, like, the 180 that a lot of these people have done. I'm like, were they always like this? You know what I mean? It's like, now it's like, I don't trust any politician, to be honest. And just, yeah, like the level, I think in this country too, we've been like conditioned to worship people, right? Before it was celebrities, or, you know, if you're into religion, you worship somebody. And it's like, I'm not an atheist. I believe that there is something bigger out there, right? I don't necessarily know what it is. I would say agnostic, maybe spiritual, whatever, but I'm definitely not religious. And like, I'm not dogmatic. So any sort of like, just complete like worshiping of anybody for me makes me uncomfortable. And I see that people are more interested in finding a hero, and you know, and maybe, and I recognize, like, when Bernie ran, I felt like, holy shit, if he wins, maybe we can change this situation. Maybe he can inspire a lot of us to change. But his whole campaign was not me, us. Like, the whole campaign was, you know, it's not about me, it's about all of you doing the work. So for me, it was, that's why I liked it, because it, what he was never like Hillary Clinton was like, right? Like, oh, this is about me, I'm with her. From the branding, it was about her. So I think a lot of people are forgetting that quote, that notion, right? It's not me, us. This is not about any figure. This is about the working people, the proletariat. So
it is. And Bernie did say, you know, he basically said, look, fuck me, do what you got to do. But then, you know, when Joe got the nomination, he did the same thing he did with Hillary. Like, look, we need to get, you know, we need to help him out. But all the real people who took Bernie to heart were said, no, I think we're going to stick to what you said before there, boss. We're not going to listen to you if you're talking this shit. And you are definitely talking shit. So but you have to wonder, like, if he, there was no way they were going to let him be the nominee. You knew that. We saw all the mechanisms that was going on to keep him out of it, so we knew it wasn't going to happen. So if there was some miracle that he actually did get the nomination, he probably would have beat Trump. But I mean, how do you think he would have been as a president in this climate now? Do you think, you know, I mean, Joe,
I think he would have been a, no, go ahead.
Oh, I was going to say, we know Joe is like an open book. He is not showing, he's not keeping any secrets about who he is. But Bernie is kind of a mystery. I mean, how do you think that would have played out?
I think Bernie Sanders would have been the closest thing to an FDR, and that's not necessarily a good thing. FDR enacted domestic policies that helped out a lot of people, but he also was an imperialist. Foreign policy wise, he was not great, obviously. You know, he didn't really do enough for Black Americans at that time. This is why when people talk, you know, uphold FDR to that degree, it's like he wasn't at all like this figure that we should really admire. And like, that was one of the things, like, I also learned, like, I used to think FDR was great until I started learning even more about foreign policy and what he didn't do and what he did do. And so for me, I think Bernie Sanders would have been like an FDR. He still would have been, you know, voting, like, he voted for the AUMF. He voted for the war in Afghanistan. He's had his votes, first pro-imperialist votes. So he's definitely not great on foreign policy. So I think Bernie would have been that type of guy. But, you know, one of the things that really irritated me about 2016 is Bernie did win. Like, he did win. That's the thing. And he would have won in 2022. We don't have a fair election system in this country. It is so blatantly obvious. I get tired of explaining it to people. We study elections. We know the ins and outs of how elections work. We have proprietary software. Public elections are run on a software that is owned by private companies, of a private company, of another private company. Like, we can't even ask for audits. We can't even do any of that. And now any sort of questioning of any election, right, from here on out, is going to be a right-wing talking point because the Republicans dared question an election. And so now that's also misguided, right? It's a right-wing thing to talk about, you know, free speech absolutism because the Republicans do it. Or it's a right-wing thing to have hesitancy on the boop boop because the Republicans do it. And so you see this manipulation, this psychological warfare that we're experiencing, where they're trying to make it so hyperpartisan for you to question things. And unfortunately, the left is going, a large contingent of the left is going right along with it, you know, just accepting and obeying. They want people to obey, like what George Carlin said. They want people that are, you know, smart enough to be a good worker but dumb enough to just like not question. And that's what people are doing. They're obeying instead of like revolting. Where is that revolution that all these people who, you know, who are obsessed with the squad talked about? Where one of the things that irritated me too about the squad is because I supported AOC heavily. I mean, we helped organize a breakfast and an entire fundraiser for AOC in California. And we had pushback from people who said, why are you guys doing that? She's a New York congresswoman, right? And our go-to was, well, you know what? She's really, we need to get more like her in office, so we're just gonna help her out here and she's gonna return the favor, hopefully. And so she took money from the working class. She took money from people who like believed in her, not just her, but Justice Democrats, right? And what the hell are they doing? They're doing nothing that they ran on, nothing. They're in fact doing going right in line with the establishment. She just voted today to fund, well, she voted present when she changed her vote from no. And present, we know, can be an escape vote after talking to Nancy Pelosi. And, you know, Jamal Bowman voted yes to fund the Iron Dome. I mean, what kind of progressives are these? Right? Yeah. What the hell kind of progressives are these? Like, they're not progressives. If that means, if Nancy Pelosi calls herself a progressive, that word has just been done.
Yeah, it's right. Done. It'd be like they dig up Hitler and you know, in German he says unzende progressive, and you're like, okay, all right. Now I think we can bury that term.